JTSD families. You know, our Science in the Parking Lot series is supposed to be so much fun, but our number one concern is student safety. So please make sure whatever you do, any of these science labs and experiments, you have adult supervision at all times and wear those safety goggles.
S-C-I-E-N-C-E.
We're doing science in the parking lot to see if these experiments work or not. We'll try and try and try some more. Parking lot science, time to explore.
Hey everybody, I'm Dr. Lowder.
And I'm Mr. Mahn.
And welcome to Science in the Parking Lot.
Science in the Parking Lot is going to be a new monthly video series. Because we realized, at JTSD, our teachers and students never stop talking about science. So this is our effort to get parents and families involved and help us engage in asking questions and wondering about all of the science happening around us.
So you might be wondering, why a parking lot? Well, we got to thinking, where can everybody do science? Science can be a little messy, science can be a little crazy. We know everybody has a parking lot or a driveway or somewhere they can get outside and make a mess. So we've chose our parking lot to shoot these videos. Come along with us and let's do some science in the parking lot.
Hey Arden, what are you doing out here in the parking lot?
For real.
Well, I noticed it was so windy outside today, I was wondering if we could do any science with air and water.
I wonder!
What just happened?
I don't know. Every time I start to wonder, this just happens to me.
Okay.
Mr. Mom, so I was thinking, Arden's question got me excited because I remember this crazy thing I saw with air and water. It had to do with air pressure.
Air pressure? Actually, no, Dr. Lauder. The air around us is pushing on us at about 14 pounds per square inch.
That is a lot. I mean, at this paint can here, this thing weighs about 8 pounds. So you mean like two of these?
Two paint cans.
Per square inch.
Per square inch. This is about a square inch. So imagine two paint cans pushing on every part of your body right now.
That's insane.
Crazy.
Well, what could we do with that, with water and air?
Well, Dr. Lauder, did you know I've heard you can use air pressure to hold water in an upside down cup?
Whoa, stop. Dr. Lauder, Mr. Mahn, better put on those safety goggles.
Good point.
Okay. All right. Let's try that again. So, like I was saying, you just take a cup of water.
All right.
And then you grab this plate. Wait, who is that?
It can't be.
Hey, Dr. Cobb, what are you doing here?
I'm just getting my kids. I'm here to pick up Aubrey and Cole.
Take a minute. Do some science with us.
Come over here.
Okay.
Might as well.
So I was just getting ready to show everybody that you can use air pressure to hold a cup of water upside down without it spilling.
Oh, that is awesome. Why don't you let me?
Oh. Never forget the safety glass.
Okay, very
safety
important.
Safety first.
Who was that again?
Safety Sue.
Safety Sue.
He's always around to help us.
Okay, safety glasses on. So I'm going to take a deck of cards. Any deck of cards will do. A deck of cards that I'm sure every parent has at home. I'm going to take the Joker, and it really doesn't matter what card you have, but if you place it right here on this cup and then turn it upside down, and then here's where the magic happens.
Gosh, that is awesome. I got a question for you.
Yeah.
You have, you know, Colby here at JTSD. What do you guys do at your home to just, you know, discover how awesome science is and wonder?
Well, it's funny that you say that, Dr. Lauder, because many times the cop kids will ask me questions at home. And instead of answering those questions, I use this simple statement, and it works every time. You go to JTSD, you figure it out.
That's perfect.
That's amazing.
Because we know scientists are good at figuring anything out.
Hey, I gotta go. I gotta pick my kids up. See you later.
Yeah, thanks, Dr. Cox. See ya.
Man, we gotta see that again.
That was insane.
So I think we need a bigger car.
I know. What if we did it with something bigger?
What do we have?
Well, let's first, we got this cup here. not only do we have this cup, but we have this awesome plate here underneath, which, it's flat like a card. I wonder what would happen if we stuck this on top like Dr. Kopp did and tried it. You want to try it?
Let's see it.
Oh! Yeah! Woo! What do you think would happen if we did it with the mug? Want to try the mug?
I'll try the plate. Let's give this a shot.
Plastic works,
cards
work.
Can you see the air pushing?
You know what I'm thinking?
You know what I was wondering?
Bigger! Yeah! Yes!
Let's do this.
You want to start with the vase?
Let's do it.
Start with the vase. I think that this plate will be just perfect. You think it's going to work?
Do I think it's going to work?
Well, air pressure should always be present, right? So it should work on this just like the cup.
14 pounds per square inch.
All right, here we go. Oh, yeah! What, do you think I can hold it over your head? That's insane. All right. I think we can try that. We're going to have to get a lot of water for that one.
Luckily.
I have a bucket. All right. What do you got there? What's this? Looks like the bottom of a fruit tray or something with some cork. Ready?
Ready.
Now I'm gonna have to have your help on this one. Hold the bucket. It's insane. Let's put this one over your head. Oh, that's insane. Oh my God! Oh, no! Man, Mr. Mahn, wasn't that insane?
Yeah. That was awesome learning about air pressure.
Yeah, science can be pretty awesome if you let it be, can't it?
Now it's your turn to try this at home.
All you gotta have is a cup, maybe a paper plate. If you don't have a paper plate, you could use a playing card. Anything that's got a slick surface and it's a little bit flexible like paper will work. Fill your cup with water, stick something on top of it, whatever your material is, flip it over, and watch the magic happen.
Hey, and while you're doing this, take a picture with your family and tag us in it on Instagram, Twitter, or send us an email.
Parking lot
science.
Time to explore.